Hello everyone. In this video, I'm gonna do reaction of organic compounds. There are actually 12 different reactions, but in this video, I'm only gonna do 10. Those 10 are related. One changes to the other and the other changes to the other. The two that I'm not gonna do in this video is oxidation, or the other name is combustion, when an alkane reacts with oxygen. And the other one is esterification, the formation of an ester. Those two will not be part of this video, but all the other reactions of organic compound will be included here. Right, our first start, we're going to start with alkenes. The alkenes are unsaturated, meaning that they have a double bond. So these reactions are the only ones that undergo addition. So in addition, what happens? The double bond becomes two single bonds and something is added on the alkene. So there are four different kind of additions that can happen with the alkenes. The first one is the addition of hydrogen. So when you have an alkene having a double bond and you add hydrogen, you're gonna end up with an alkane. So this kind of a reaction is called addition. All the alkenes, they undergo addition. This reaction is addition reaction, and then it has a special name because you are adding a hydrogen. It's a hydrogenation. It's an addition of hydrogen. The double bond that you had is broken down to single bond and hydrogen. Because hydrogen is diatomic molecule, you'll have two hydrogen molecules. Then they'll attach themselves there. You'll end up with alkane. You'll have all saturated all single bond. Now, very important to remember here is the reaction condition. What do you need for this reaction to happen? You need a catalyst. You only need to memorize one. So this is platinum. Platinum is a catalyst. So let's go to the next reaction. The next reaction is also an addition reaction when an alkene forms a haloalkane. So this reaction is also, all the alkenes are going under addition. So this is an addition reaction. Now, when an alkene undergoes addition and then you end up with a haloalkane, there are two kinds of reaction that can do that. The first one is when you add a halogen. So when you add a halogen, the reaction is called, it's an addition reaction, and with a special name is halogenation. Halogenation, because you are adding a halogen. Now, a halogen, we do it like that. That represent, you can either add bromine or add chlorine. So that process will be halogenation. What is the reaction condition? What do you need for this reaction to happen? For this reaction to happen, the reaction condition, there must be no water added, right? And then I said the alkenes, they'll form a haloalkane. There are two reactions. So the first one is, all these, they form addition. There is halogenation. We are adding a halogen and no water should be present. So the other one, it's also addition, is hydrohalogenation. You are adding a hydrogen halide. A hydrogen halide is hydrogen chloride or hydrogen bromide. And then the reaction conditions are the ones that I'm writing in red. You must have water-free hydrogen halide. And then you'll be forming a haloalkane. Now, when you see these two reactions, they're giving us haloalkane. How would you know that you were doing halogenation, meaning adding a halogen, or hydrohalogenation, meaning that you were adding a hydrogen halide? You'll see with a product. If the product, what is formed, it has two halogens, maybe 1,2-dibromo, then you know that it is halogenation. If it has one halogen, then you know that it is the hydrohalogenation. When that double bond broke, one of the bond took hydrogen, one of the bond took chlorine or bromine. But with this one, the halogenation, you had two halogens. So two of the bonds that broke from the double bond from alkene, they will both take a bromine and a bromine. So your name, your IUPAC name, will have 1,2-dibromo. Then you know it's halogenation, not hydrohalogenation. Now let's look at the name. Hydrohalogenation.
you're telling that we have a hydrogen and a halide, right? Let's look at the last reaction of alkanes addition. You have four additions. So the fourth one, let's look at the fourth one, right? The fourth addition reaction, when you have a double bond forming an alcohol, the double bond is going to break. So it's an addition reaction. And then it's hydration. Hydration is addition of water. If you have an alkene, unsaturated double bond, and then you add water, that process is called hydration. And then you're going to end up with an alcohol. Now, what is the reaction condition? You need sulfuric acid as a catalyst in this reaction to happen. Now, these are the four addition reactions that the organic compounds go through. The first one is this one, is hydration, is the addition of hydrogen. The second one is addition of halogen, and it's halogenation. The third one is the addition of hydrogen halide, and is hydrohalogenation. And the last one, the fourth one, is hydration, is the addition of water. The alkenes, they are the only reaction that go through addition. Let's look at the next one. Now, the reverse of addition is elimination. All the other homologous series, except for the alkene, they go through elimination. If we go through elimination with the alkanes, we end up with the alkenes. Elimination here with the haloalkanes, we'll end up with the alkenes. Eliminations with alcohols will end up with the alkene. Meaning that double bond that was broken with addition, when we eliminate, we form the double bond and come back to this one. When you have alkanes, single bond, and you eliminate them, when you eliminate, to eliminate is to take something out. When you eliminate, you end up with alkenes, double bond. So when alkanes are eliminated, the process is called cracking. It's when longer carbon chains are broken to shorter ones, which are more usable. There are two forms of cracking that we have. We have a catalytic cracking, where our reaction condition is a catalyst, and we have thermal cracking. Thermal is heat, where you use high temperature and high pressure. Okay, the catalyst that you use is the same as that one. The catalyst that you use for addition is the same catalyst that you use for elimination. Right, let's go for elimination in haloalkanes. Right, when haloalkanes form alkenes, the process is called elimination. Here we have saturated, meaning single bond. You're going to form a compound that has a double bond. The process is elimination, is the reverse of the addition. So the name is dehydrohalogenation. D meaning reverse. Dehydrohalogenation. You want to reverse a halogen and a hydrogen. What is the reaction condition? What do you need for the process to happen? You need a concentrated strong base. So I've written an example of a concentrated strong base. Concentrated sodium hydroxide. So when you have the reaction, you'll see you'll have another reaction where you have a dilute. So when they give you the reaction condition, look at whether it's concentrated or it's dilute. It will change the reaction of a halogen. Like the elimination of alcohol, where you remove water. So the process is called elimination, and the name is dehydration. You need sulfuric acid, strong acid as a catalyst, and the whole reaction must be strongly heated. So the alcohol will form an alkene. So you have three kinds of elimination. The first one, elimination, is cracking when an alkane forms an alkene. The next one is dehydrohalogenation, where a halogen forms an alkene. And the third one is dehydration, when an alcohol forms an alkene. Right, the third kind of reaction that the organic compounds go through is substitution. When you substitute, like they do in soccer, when somebody, one player goes out and the other one gets in the position of the other one, that's what happens in substitution. So with substitution, an atom will move out of an alkane and something else will move in. So if that thing that moves in is a halogen, so that will be halogenation. So the halogenation, the alkane will be forming a haloalkane. And then the reaction condition, what is needed for the reaction to happen, is sunlight. Or sometimes you can write UV light.
But when a haloalkane forms an alcohol, the reaction is called substitution, and it means the atoms are going to be changed when it go out. And then the process is called hydrolysis. And then the reaction condition, you need a dilute strong base. Here I've used dilute sodium hydroxide. So I want you to notice something here. When we are working with haloalkanes, when they give you in a question paper haloalkanes, you need to look at, did they give you concentrated strong base or dilute strong base? If it's concentrated strong base, it will form elimination. If it's dilute strong base, it will be substitution. It will form an alcohol. So you need to look at this. You need to look at them. Which one did they give you? If it's concentrated, it's going to be elimination. When it's dilute, it's going to be substitution. Right? When alcohols undergo substitution and they'll be forming haloalkanes, so the alcohol will be reacting with hydrogen halide, and then it will form a haloalkane. The process will be called halogenation. This will be a substitution process, and then the sulfuric acid will be used as a catalyst, and the alcohol must be slowly heated, then it will form a haloalkane. So you need to look at the video, memorize the video, and then write the whole process on your own. If you can write them, write everything, then when you get a question, it will be easy for you to get work, because this question in the exam, they ask it in flow diagram. So if you are used to, in your mind, putting it in a flow diagram like this, you'll be able to get all the answers. This is the end of my lesson. Thank you for watching.